well, quite impressive to be the first one. I'm coming from IRCAM, that's an institute of research in Paris, and we are specialized in research in terms of audio and music and all the development that we can have, and we try to work for the future. That means I'm not going to show you some old technology, but I just want to show you what we try to do in research. Then the first thing that I want to show you is IRCAM was like this 35 years ago. It was a big hall in the center of Paris next to the Centre Pompidou. And we create 6,000 square meters of research engineers and technicians to develop technologies. Then in the when we created IRCAM in the 1970s, all the people was using this kind of instruments and this kind of analog instruments like Moog and all these synthesizers that you can find on the market in 30 years. But as you can see, Pierre Boulez was creating the IRCAM, and you see the main difference that he was on the digital domain from the beginning. That this man was thinking about digital audio in the 1973. That we worked on this problematic since now than 4 than 35 years. We have a lot of technology. We have 80 researchers, 10 different departments working on audio, especially working on the gestural following, working on what we call identity converter. Like, I'm recording the voice of the woman here during 1 hour, and after that you are taking a microphone, and in real time the machine is going to convert your voice to the woman voice. And we try to really to develop some new technologies. The IRCAM is now like this. It's 6,000 square meters, 150 people working in it, 80 researchers, 10 departments. And most of the prototypes that we designed since 30 years was done on Max MSPs, and maybe some of you know this technology. It's a kind of toolbox. And the idea was to create a Max object from the research department, convert them to the Max MSP patch, and like this, all the composers that we have at the IRCAM can create and work on the music with this new technology. Then that was the idea. The main problem is that this technology is quite difficult to understand, and if you are not a maxer, and if you are not a real creator of patch max, it's quite difficult to create instruments. That's why we decide to create IRCAM Tools by Flux. Then we developed a technology with a plugin connection with a French company named Flux. And the idea was to put directly the science, let's say, that the technology coming from the research directly to the market. We tried to create original instruments, and I'm going to show you two main plugins today. One is named Trax. It's a special plugin to modify voices or solo instruments or music. And the second one is named the SPAT. It's a multi, it's a tool that you can use to make spatialization for the cinema, for video games, so sound designing, radio, etc., etc. Then the collection now is more than 5 products. Then we put the SPAT. We have a Verb. It's an acoustic simulation. 25 years of works and research on the acoustic perceptive value that we can have, and Track Modifier. We create 2 other plugins this year. Now is named the Verb Session. It's a small Verb. That means we create a big Verb with something like 130 parameters. And when we went to the music business, when we went to the cinema business, most of the engineers was asking us to have something more easy to use with the same quality than the Verb. That's the reason why we create the Verb Session with less parameters, but with the same quality. That means you can create presets on the main one and then having them on the small one. The main difference is the price. The first one is £700, and the small one is £149. That means that you can create and getting the quality of the reverb, of the IRCAM reverb, for £149. And the last one is named Ear, and that's an interesting plugin for all people who want to work in 5.1 or multi-channel technology. That means we can directly simulate through headphones, sorry, the 5 speakers in your headphone. That means you can work in 5.1 on your host, and then put in the Ear plugin directly on the output of your host, and working in headphones, and then we are going to simulate the 5 speakers in different acoustic and different rooms. Then like this, we can keep and working in the train in 5.1, that is not possible before. The quality on the ear, it's a technology coming from the SPAT. That means step by step we are taking the SPAT is a real full instrument, full of the, all the technology that we put inside. And we try to put now certain technology outside to specify plugin. Let's go quickly. That's tracks. Okay, that's a voice modifier. I'm going to make you a demo quickly. Then we have the Verb, that's an acoustic simulator, and we have the SPAT. Then you can see on the SPAT, then you can directly simulate and put, making position of all your sources. Then if you are working in stereo, 4-0, 5-1, we can go to 9-1 now. And we are putting a new SPAT at the end of September, is what we call the NHK format, is 22-2. That means 22 speakers, and two for one for the top and one for the low frequencies. Okay, let's go to the demo because I know that we are under the schedule. Okay, then the first demo, it's around tracks. Okay, the first thing that we are going to do, the song please.
Il s'agit de réduire la consommation d'énergie dans l'habitat, notamment.
Okay, then I take a pure French journalist. Sorry, it is going to be in French, but the modification is going to be the same anyway. Then the first thing that we are going to do, it's learning. We are going to learn what we call F0, that's the main frequency of the voices. That means everyone gets to kind of specialize in terms of melody at the way you are speaking and the way you are talking. Then the machine now learns
que la loi Grenelle 2 doit être votée parmi les propositions de l'ordre périmé, il y a la norme BBC, bâtiment.
Then you have the two main parameters there, and here you have what we call voice forger and the special parameters for modifying the voices. That means we can easily
que la loi Grenelle 2 doit être votée par les propositions qu'elle doit entériner, il y a la norme BBC, bâtiment basse consommation.
Then you can go to the male function of the male.
L'énergie dans l'habitant, dans l'habitat, notamment grâce à l'isolation. Voici ce que serait main que la loi Grenelle 2 doit être votée. Main que la loi Grenelle.
And by the fact that IRCAM will try to push this technology, because you have this kind of modifier from Isotope or from different company. But we, this, the interest of the IRCAM, and we push the searchers to find the mathematical solution for the glottis. And that's what we did with these parameters. Then suddenly we can block your glottis and having the noise, and only the noise of your voice. That one of these original parameters.
Parmi les propositions qu'elle doit entériner, il y a la norme bâtiment basse.
Now the other thing is that by the fact that we learn the melody of your voice, we can flat it. That means
que la loi Grenelle 2 doit être votée. Parmi les propositions qu'elle doit entériner, il y a la norme BBC.
Okay, there are no more melodies, and we could just reduce the melody, but we can go. On the other side, that means we can exaggerate.
La loi Grenelle 2 doit être votée. Parmi les propositions qu'elle doit entériner, il y a la norme BBC. Bâtiment basse consommation. Il s'agit de réduire la consommation des.
Now we can, let's say, we can play with it. That means you have different parameters to modify voices. The interest of this plugin, especially for the cinema, especially for all the people working for the video games, and you know, we are recording for a normal video game something like 200,000 different phrases coming most of the time from 50 or 60 different actors. By this technology, we just reduce the quantity of actors to 15, and you can create additional voices from only one voice. You can go to male, to female, to children, and everything. Now let's modify.
Que la loi Grenelle 2 doit être votée parmi les propositions.
Then you can exaggerate the effects down.
Que la loi Grenelle 2 doit être votée parmi les propositions qu'elle doit entériner, il y a la norme BBC.
Then let's go to woman now.
Que la loi Grenelle 2 doit être votée parmi les propositions qu'elle doit entériner,
il y a la norme BBC. Bâtiment basse consommation. Il s'agit de réduire la consommation d'énergie dans l'habitat, notamment grâce à l'isolation.
Then we import different modifications just to go to the grandmother, the grandfather voice. Then you can modify.
Que la loi Grenelle 2 doit être votée. Parmi les propositions qu'elle doit entériner, il y a la norme BBC.
Okay, that's the different parameters. Then you can anyway save and you can preset and recall any presets of the voices. Anyway, you have an input, you have a filters, high and low cut filters, and you can directly having a kind of telephone voice, or you can modify, you know, one more time the character of the voice. On the other side, we create what we call the day and night functions. When you are working in the cinema, when you have a screen, it's fully white. That means when you are in the cinema rooms, you always have the screen, this white screen disturbing your view of the main screen of the film. That's why but when you're on stage, if you are dark, that you don't see anything on the screen, that's why we put the day and night functions. Then like this, you can directly adjust your plugin as you wish. But I can say on the top of it, okay, here you have voice modification, but we can go to instruments modification. When I talk about instruments, I'm talking about monophonic instruments, flute, saxophone, trumpets. I'm not talking about polyphonic instruments like piano or horn. And in this case, you need to go to the music staff. It's three different algorithms just to be sure that the quality of the transformation is going to be the best, okay? Now if we are going to different examples, for sure, we can.
Walking down the palace steps, a worried voice.
Tightening, her makeup must have been.
He's working on single voices, for sure. Then you can directly transform to woman, you can transform to low voice, and you can directly transform
to low voice.
Now, what is interesting is just to see what we can do with the original voices. Then what you are going to listen, the first voice is going to be the original one, and after that, all the voices you are going to listen is coming from tracks. Okay, the first one is the original one.
The princess crying, walking down the palace steps, a worried voice, tightening her makeup.
Second voice.
In a mess.
The princess crying, walking down the palace steps, a worried voice, tightening her makeup.
Third one. That's a low voice. You can transform it to go to the flat voice.
The princess crying, walking down the palace steps. A worried princess crying.
And now we put the four voices together.
Being a mess, the princess crying, walking down the palace steps. A worried voice, tightening.
Okay, so that's a demo. I'm trying to be in time. That's a quick demo of tracks. The interest that when we compare the algorithm to what you have on the market, for the moment we are still number one. Let's say then IRCAM is working on this technology and on these resources since nearly 20 years now. And the quality of this algorithm is linked to the fact that IRCAM is one of the only institutes when we are mixing searchers, engineers, and musicians and composers. That means musicians and composers are asking for special parameters or to adjust special defaults that you can have in the technology, and then the research is coming back with a new object. And that's why we have a kind of quality of the transformation. And TV are using a lot now this kind of technology just to transform the voices for different documentaries, then they need to mask the original voices. But the interest of this technology is that you can completely transform the voice without, you are not obliged to have subtitles just to let them know what's going on, you know, what it's talking about. We are using that for cinema, voiceover, and linked to that, we are going to put on the market this identity converter, this voice, this transformer voices. It should be really interesting for the cinema, for all the voiceover. We can now go, we try to work now to recreate the Marilyn Monroe voices through the recordings. We did it with Winston Churchill, which, you know, just gets the recording from the 1940s. We put that in the machine. The only problem that we have is the quality of the recordings in the 1940s. then we don't have, you know, a perfect voice as a church here. But when the voice is perfect, you have a real identity converter, and it's really working well. That's what we did last year by wishing the Happy New Year to the Barack Obama voice. Now I'm going to use the other technology. And then this one is a spat. Well, this is a spat. Okay, now, the idea, the first idea of the spat, then you can firstly create your acoustic simulation. That means you can work on stereo, but you can work through all these different formats until the B format, okay? Then up to 8071, then all the stuff that you can have on the cinema or video games. Okay, let's say that we're in stereo today, then we can fix it. And here, you have how you are going to listen your works. That means we're going to these angular pairwise speakers, but you can go to these binaurals and what I talk about here, that is simulation of the five speakers or the four speakers in your headphones. Now you have three different reverbs, three different acoustics. That means each sources can be in three different acoustics to make the simulation of a room. And here you have all your different sources. Alors, the number of sources is limited to your host. That means if you are on Pro Tools, you can go to maximum to 8 sources. If you are going to, I think it's Stenberg, you can go to 16 different sources on one spat. The CPU consumption is something like 3 or 4%. That's absolutely nothing. And you can purely simulate the spat. And let's play with it now. That's, we have a guitar here. Okay. Alors, firstly, all the perceptive parameters are going to be directly linked to the spat. That means if you are in a cinema scene and you have a car coming and going far away, you just have to take the sources and move it from 10 meters to 100 meters, we can go maximum. That means if you are here, you can see on the sources, you can see the distance of the spat. That means you can directly put the sound more closer from the speakers or from your head, okay? Then all the sources can be directly modified by this. The second parameter that you have is when are you going to place your sources in your multi-format setting. After that, we have what we call the yo. That means I'm talking through this direction, or I'm talking to this direction. Then all these perceptive parameters are going to be included in the spat. After that, we work on what we call the elevation, then how we can simulate the sound of the rain coming down, coming from the top to the floor. Then we try to work on this elevation. Alors, let's say that it's working well on speakers, on headphones, sorry, but when you're on speakers, it's more difficult to feel it. And the other thing is what we call the aperture. That means how the sources is reacting in the acoustic of the room. Then is is this piece of sound is really, in the room or not? And you can adjust it and you see it by, the simulation that you have here. And you can see the trees. And if I'm going there, you can put the acoustic and adjust the system directly to your setting. Where are we? We are okay? 2 minutes? Okay, now just to finish, because you know, now you can download this technology directly by demo on the website, on the IRCAM website, and you can test it without any protections. What I would like to finish is just to say that at IRCAM we just feel that developers are going to be the new star of the electronics technology. That means the musician is not the star anymore. The musician is a user. But now the real creator are the developers and the searchers. That we try to make a lot of innovation. We try to work on something new, just to give you new technology and to give you new new way to produce and to mix. And by the fact that's why we create the SPAT and why we create ears. Now we pass to 70% of the population are listening to music through headphones. They are not listening to music through speakers anymore. That means that we really want to improve the quality of what you are going to listen in your two headphones. That's what we are. I think it's done for me.
Wonderful. Frederick, thanks so much.
Have a nice day. Thank you. Just one more thing. I leave some cards of the IRCAM just somewhere on the desk. And if you are passing by Paris, please welcome. You can see what, because it's just, you know, an extract of what we are doing. Then you have some cards if you wish to come to the IRCAM and visit us.
And Frederick, you're going to be around for the whole of today.
Yeah.
So catch up with Frederick.
Yeah, you can find me. I am a yellow jacket, like your skis, you know, like your stickers, and you can find me easily.
Wonderful. Thanks again.
Thank you.
Great. Right.